We're really excited to announce at Caltech this new initiative called the RoAM initiative. What RoAM stands for is Robotic Assisted Mobility. And the idea of the RoAM initiative is to take ideas from robotics, from neurocontrol, and put them together to help people live better lives, to help restore mobility, especially in the context of bipedal locomotion. I'm Aaron Ames. I'm the Bren Professor of Mechanical and Civil Engineering and Control and Dynamical Systems here at Caltech, and we're standing in the Amber Lab. For a long time, our central focus has been realizing dynamic and efficient walking on bipedal robots. That is, how do we capture the efficient and elegant way that humans walk dynamically in a robotic context? What's interesting is, in this process of studying dynamic locomotion from a control theory perspective, from a mathematical perspective, is the application of this to understanding how to make humans walk better. That is, how do we take what we know about robotic walking for bipedal robots and translate that to help people walk again, walk better, walk more efficiently, and more importantly, restore locomotion for people? Professor Joel Burdick in mechanical and civil engineering, he's discovered with his collaborators that if you stimulate the spinal cord, that they can actually get the legs to start to fire again. They've gotten paraplegics to stand with their own legs by stimulating their spinal cord.
The first time you actually see a patient stand up, you're hooked. You just don't go back. Yes, I'm Joel Burdick. I'm the Richard and Dorothy Heyman Professor of Mechanical Engineering and Bioengineering. More than 20 years ago, I started working with Professor Richard Anderson here at Caltech on brain-machine interfaces. We've been developing both the implantable technology and now a non-implantable technology to stimulate the spinal cord. So that's a central piece of our approach, is to sort of revive the damaged circuits below the injury and to kind of trick them into thinking that they're talking to the brain. And so part of RoAM now is to go even one step further, to have the robots coordinate with the spinal stimulation, not only to improve spinal function, but allow people to go out and actually use the robots in their daily lives.
Really, we seem to be at a cusp here. We have all these algorithms for robots that had no human involved whatsoever. So now we have to put a human in the loop and think about how to take those dynamic algorithms with the human playing a part.
What we hope to do is coordinate how the stimulation changes in real time with actually how the exoskeleton is moving. So as you're moving through the gait cycle, when you lift your leg up, we'll probably want to adjust the electrodes a little bit to give a little more extra oomph to the leg that's still standing, and also to encourage the leg, which is now in the swing phase, to actually sort of, you know, more naturally go forward. And so by hitting them both with the robot side, which is the mechanical part, and the stimulator, the electrical part, we can then make sure the circuits learn the proper coordination as well.
What we're trying to do is break boundaries. When you start talking about putting a robot on a person, you have to change the paradigm in which you think about what a robot is. And with that comes new science at every level of the robotic system and the way it works with the person to achieve the ultimate goal. We can actually make a positive effect on people's lives in a day-to-day basis. Their quality of life can improve if we can restore mobility for them. And I think this deserves, and in fact requires, our intellectual effort to try to solve this problem.